Hey everybody, how are you? I just want to do a quick Facebook Live about the concept of punishment and about the concept of some of the dogs that we work with and why we're such advocates of, this is John, he's my head trainer.
Hello.
Just the concept of why a dog needs to have a balanced training program as far as reward and punishment. So John, talk to me about this particular dog you've got with you.
So this is Gibbs. He came in, he's got a ton of nips on his record.
Well, 12, 10 or 12?
Yeah.
Okay.
About that.
And what does he do? What's his most popular way to bite? Just on a walk?
It sounds like they have him off leash and off on leash, and he nips at people's hands when they come too close or when they try to pet him or anything
okay.
like that.
And then some of them have been deep puncture wounds?
Yeah, I think it was redirecting on the owner was the big puncture.
Okay.
But most of the people have been quick.
So a big trigger for this dog is, say you're walking by another dog, someone goes out to reach, and the dog bites the hand. So obviously we can talk about how you shouldn't go try to pet random dogs, obviously, but also we have to desensitize this dog to stop biting at people if they happen to reach for them. Mm-hmm. So the concept of punishment, so this dog, when it first came in, obviously was going after, you know, all the staff of hands, things like that, and it's been punished. When we talk about punishment, I think the conversation has to be, it's not abusive. Punishment is just matter of fact, just like praise is matter of fact. So this dog has been punished today because it was, this is somebody new, Enrique is somebody new, so he's been helping out, and you're going to see a dog that it's okay to punish a dog. It doesn't shut the dog down, but even if it did shut the dog down in the moment, it's okay. You are suppressed, you're trying to suppress the concept of the dog being punished. But now what we're going to do is we're going to see a protocol when it's going to be reward-based. So you're going to see how we reward dogs for making the right decisions and if we have to punish dogs for making the wrong decisions. So this is a little exercise we're going to do, and John and Enrique is going to do this. This is going to be done with a food and a clicker, and they're going to do pass-by. So as soon as John walks by Enrique or Enrique walks by John, John is going to say heel. The dog is going to look up to John, and then what's going to happen, there's going to be a click, which is a marker, and then John will deliver food. The clicker obviously takes a picture in the moment of time when we like what the dog does, and then it's followed up with food reward, or it could be praise, or it could be a toy, it could be anything. So this is the concept of balanced training. And here we go.
Let's go. Heel. Heel. Okay.
So what you're going to do is, as long as the dog is not, you guys might have to watch the replay, sorry guys. So as long as the dog does not stare at Enrique and think naughty thoughts, the dog will be rewarded.
Heel. Good.
So notice how he's looking away.
Heel.
Just watch the replay, guys. You can't tolerate the clicker noise? All right.
Heel.
Then you might want to shut this off and don't use one for training.
They also make clickers with really lower. Like,
yeah, they make a clicker with a lower thing. Yep.
Low pitch.
Heel. Heel.
Yep. Do you know what I can't stand? If you can't stand the clicker, you know what's worse than a clicker? A biting dog.
Heel.
In my opinion.
Heel.
And there's many ways to rehab dogs. You don't have to use a clicker if you don't want to. Now what we're going to do is, I think Enrique is probably going to walk close, and John is going to get the dog to don't focus on Enrique. I think that's what they're about to
yes.
do. Okay, so watch this.
Heel. Yes.
Boom. There we go.
Heel.
There we go.
Nice. Heel.
Bingo. There we go.
Heel.
There we go. Excellent.
Heel.
Good. Excellent.
Heel.
Very good.
Heel.
Very good. Awesome. Awesome. All right, guys, thanks. I'll leave you alone. Let me just turn this around. So that's the concept. There's a lot of different concepts on how we train. So what I've been trying to do is I've been trying to get everybody, you know, involved with the training that we do here. It doesn't make a difference who clicks. Again, we've always used marker words. We've always used yes. We've switched over to clicker for a lot just because the more work that I do with clickers, the more people that we that I learn from, the more seminars that I go to. I've got a new staff member here that does clicker training for a ton of stuff. So what we've done is we've just trying to incorporate, how can we motivate these dogs to do what we want and to not do what we don't want, sticking to the reward-punishment model, which is the balanced training. So we're always looking to motivate dogs. We want to motivate them to do what we want through reward. We want to motivate them to do what we don't want not do what they want. Cindy, that's the word that John has decided to use, because in motion, heel means at your side, at your pace, focused on the handler. And that's just the word that John has been using, because now when he's in motion and the dog starts looking at someone else, he'll say heel, the dog will make sure the dog is focused on him. So in a way, it really doesn't matter what word that you do use, as long as you're consistent with your training. So it really doesn't matter the word you use. The point of it being is when the dog is listening to you, you reward the dog. And keep in mind, whenever you're doing clicker training, it's not forever. It's not forever. It's just to shape the dog's behavior. So one more thing that I wanted to show everybody out there, just to maybe that could help people. The bottom line is when you, stepping on a dog's tail right now, is when you're trying to get a dog to stop a bad behavior, you need to punish it. And when you're trying to get a dog to do more of what you want, you're going to reward it. So simple concepts. And we just want to make sure that we put out as much information as possible so people can get as much help as possible. Because people are killing dogs. People are surrendering dogs. I really want it to stop. I'm looking for everybody out there to have just a minimum baseline of obedience with their dog. I want all dogs to at least understand the concepts of sit, down, place, heel, recall, go in your kennel, be quiet in your kennel, no barking, no lunging. And I think it's really, really nice to understand that also then you have good manners. So we've got obedience commands, good manners. I think those things are really, really, really important. Obviously, proper nutrition, proper exercise, obviously are very, very important, both physical and mental stimulation. So there's a lot to it. If you follow us on Facebook, follow us on Periscope, follow us on Instagram, you'll see that we're trying to put out as much free content to help as many people as possible. But this concept that punishment is bad, nope, it's important. If that dog was not punished, it would have bitten Enrique. If that dog was not punished, it would have bitten John. So I think sometimes when you look at things from one-sided, saying, oh, punishment is bad, well, what would you do with a dog that's bitten 10 people? You'd kill it, right? You'd kill it. So, you know, we're trying to keep these dogs alive. And we don't just work with biting dogs. We work with all dogs. But here's a great example where, you know, punishment is absolutely mandatory in the dog's life. And as far as I'm concerned, punishment is mandatory in all dogs' lives. But that's the balance. That's the balance. So 90% of this day, that dog will work probably for half an hour. It might get punished once or twice. Each one of those punishments will last anywhere from 1 to 3 seconds. So just think about that. Think about that. So 1 to 3 seconds from 30 minutes of training. That's not so bad. That's not so bad at all. So there's 86,400 seconds, you know, per day. You're not spending much time punishing a dog. Okay? Jeff Gellman, Solid Canine Training, madly in love with all of you. And keep up the awesome work. Super proud of so many of you who are really, really stepping up your game to work with your own dogs. All my fellow trainers out there, you know, I love how you're just implementing all kinds of great information. All right? Since starting to incorporate discipline with my dogs, I've seen so much change. Yep. It's sort of like kids. Don't discipline your kids. Good luck with that theory. Don't discipline your dog. Good luck with that theory. Employees. Like, discipline is not a negative thing. Discipline is not a negative thing. So, you know, if there was an employee here that, I mean, here's a great example. Okay. So we have this. Okay, here we go. Here's a great example. I'm going to turn this around. See this refrigerator? This is Amanda, by the way. Amanda keeps her lunch right in there. Now, she doesn't need the whole refrigerator. She doesn't eat that much lunch. But her lunch is in this refrigerator. Okay? Could you imagine if one of the other employees just went in there and took her lunch? No, see, I'm being really serious here. It has happened, right? So could you imagine if another staff member took her lunch? Should there not be a consequence for that? Should there not be a consequence? And this is a really great example. Like, discipline, you know, discipline is a fact of life. Punishment is a fact of life. So what would the consequence be? The employee wouldn't be fired, not the first time. But if they made a habit out of it, of course you'd have to. You know, you'd have to punish, you'd have to terminate that employee. They're stealing someone else's lunch because they had a choice not to do it. They had a choice not to do it. So, you know, we live in a world of discipline. Discipline keeps anarchy from happening. Remember that with dogs and with people. All right. Take care. Madly in love with all of you. Keep going strong.